Hello, everybody, and good day. This is Fred with Tech Talk and Wentworth CCTV, and we are coming at you today with a video on what to do in the event you want to pull up Hikvision hardware, whether it be a NVR, DVR, or networked IP camera using a browser. Okay, if you've used Hikvision equipment in the past, this has been a sour spot for a lot of people. With DAWA, you can pull cameras up in any browser without any plugins, and it seems pretty seamless. With Hikvision, there are a lot of issues unless you use old school Explorer. I have found a way to pull up Hikvision hardware, whether it's a new camera or old camera, using Windows 11 and the new Microsoft Edge. It's a simple process. We're going to cover it right now. All right, let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, please subscribe to our channel if you have not yet done so. There is a subscribe button in the bottom right corner of your screen. Also, like this video if the content is useful to you, and as always, leave comments. A lot of our videos are based on subscriber questions and comments. So yes, the first thing we want to do is pull up our hardware. And again, by hardware, I mean IP camera, NVR, or DVR by its IP address. Okay, if you do not know how to port forward or how to pull up a device by its IP address, please watch the video going across your screen on the top right now. That covers that portion, port forwarding. Basically, we're pulling up this device by its IP address on your local network, if you're connected locally, or by your static or dynamic IP address that your internet service provider gave you to connect remotely. Okay, in this case I'm connecting to a fisheye camera that is remote. So at that location, the fisheye has been networked and it has been port forwarded. Again, the video is going across the top of your screen right now to walk you through that part. We don't have time in this video. So as you can see, I've entered the IP address of that location in my browser address bar. I have, for security reasons, blacked out the last three digits of the IP address because I don't want you clowns logging in there. Okay, but what you're gonna do is you're gonna enter that IP address into your browser, okay? Once you do that, you'll be brought to the login screen for that device, okay? So I'm gonna enter my credentials. And what happens in Edge, we're in Microsoft Edge using Windows 11, you will get the infamous screen of death requesting you to install the plugin, right? Everybody's seen this before, it's very frustrating. So you can install the plugin all you want. Give me a hard time, isn't it? Let's go up there, come on, fella. Okay, web components, we're going to open it up. Sorry about the annoying beep. Yes, we're going to install web components. It tells us it finished, beautiful. So this is where people have fits. We've done it, we should be able to refresh the browser and look at our cameras, correct? No, it's a vicious loop. We just get brought back to the screen time and time again and people pull their hair out. So how do we fix this? It's very simple. We're going to go to the top right corner of your screen and you'll see these three dots. Okay, we're going to click there and we're going to come down here to settings. And once you click settings, in the left hand menu bar you will see default browser. Okay, we want to click that, folks. Once you click default browser, okay, you'll see make legacy sites work with Microsoft Edge. Okay, we want that to be clicked always. Okay, so put that on always. What this is saying is if you're using hardware that works better with Microsoft Explorer, to go ahead and let Edge use Explorer for just those legacy softwares. Allow sites to be reloaded on Internet Explorer. We want to allow that. Okay, You could be on don't allow or default. We want to be on allow. The last thing we want to do, Internet Explorer mode pages. When we add something, when we add a URL here, it is going to bypass Edge and go to Explorer for that particular URL. So what are we going to do? We're going to go back to our camera. We already talked about the IP address and how we obtain that. We're going to copy that and we're going to paste that right here where it says enter URL. And we're going to hit add. And what you'll see is it added that URL, which is our camera, to the Internet Explorer mode page. Okay, so now when we go here and we refresh, we will see a new message in our toolbar. It says you're in Internet Explorer mode. Okay, perfect, that's what we want. So now we can do admin and we'll enter our password. And with any luck, we will be logging in to our fisheye remotely. Use a Microsoft Edge in Windows 11. That's great. Look at that, folks. There it is. Okay. If you've never used a fisheye, they are a little bit funky. They do give you that 360 view. my picture is kind of in the way here, but there are different display modes. So you can do the fisheye with kind of four cameras that you can move based on these squares. It's really a neat deal. But again, this video is not about a fisheye. That will be a video for a future day. But hopefully you enjoyed this content. This really is a useful tool. I know it's been giving me fits for years that you have to use not updated software and old school Explorer to pull up cameras. You should be able to use the latest version of a browser and the manufacturer of the laptop or computer's latest operating system. So that's what we're doing. Like I said, this is Windows 11. This is the latest and greatest Microsoft Edge, and we're looking at our Hikvision camera. This will work with any Hikvision camera DVR. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. We will see you in the field.